countries.
By noted director Sudhir Mishra on the phone line. Mr. Mishra, many thanks, and we understand it is an absolutely heartbreaking, crushing moment for the Bollywood fraternity, having lost two of the legends. And this is extremely heartbreaking, the news of a veteran iconic actor like Rishi Kapoor passing away, who's admired, who's revered, who's looked up to in the Bollywood industry like no other.
Yeah, I mean, this is a very difficult reaction, especially coming on the heels of Irfan going yesterday. And I mean, it's what do you say? I mean, everything that you can say about Rishi Kapoor will come up short. You know, I mean, he's an actor. You see his work from Mera Naam Joker to Mulk. You know, I mean, it's a fascinating the way he's reinvented himself now from that romantic hero to this actor now, this person who spoke his mind very, very... they don't make him like that. You know, he was a fascinating, amazing person. You know, I grew up watching him. You know, he's just a little older than me. It's like part of you is gone, you know. Like part of your childhood is gone, your youth is gone. Because he represented so much for people like me, you know. It's one regret that will always remain. I almost worked with him and then didn't. And I didn't finish. I wanted to do a film with him called Mehrun Nisa. Him and Amit Ji, and never happened. Now that it won't happen, and that regret will remain. What can you say? It's too difficult.
Mr. Mishra, we understand it is extremely difficult. Mr. Sudhir Mishra, request you to stay with us at this point. Let me go across to noted actor Shakti Kapoor, who is joining us on the broadcast. Shakti Kapoor, many thanks for speaking to us, and I'm sure it is an absolutely devastating, difficult moment for you personally, having worked with Rishi Kapoor on a multiple project, multiple films, having loved to see both of you on screen.
What's happening is I'm so scared every morning to pick up my phone, because when you pick up a phone, you get such drastic, such devastating news, and this news I couldn't digest, you know, because Rishi and I have been a long way back. Our relation starts from a way back when we were just 20, 21, and he is one day younger to me. 3rd September I was born, 4th September he's born. We cut cakes together, we walked into about 20-25 films together. My family is very close to RK Studios. Mr. Raj Kapoor, my sister-in-law, Padmini Kolhapuri, was Satyam Shivam Sundaram Prem Rogue. When I got married, Chintu's mother, Rishi Kapoor's mother, blessed me. They called me to the Timbur Bungalow, me and my wife. They blessed me, gave me a packet of money, and they keep this little girl happy. And Rishi Kapoor and I've been in touch for the last 15 days. I've been messaging him, and he wasn't replying. I used to sing songs for him when he was in New York hospital. I used to make him laugh, and he used to tell me, "Sharks, don't worry, I'm going to be coming back." Then one day he spoke to me and said, "Shakti, 8 months ho gaye, main wapas kab aaunga yaar? 8 months ho gaye hospital." And he came back, and he said, "I won." And he started shooting ready for the same film he was shooting 1 year earlier when he went, this cancer was detected. And he went and shot again for the same film in Delhi. And while he was shooting again in Delhi, he was unwell. He said, "I'm unwell." I said, "Chintu, come back to Bombay. Don't shoot for this film in Delhi. Come to guys and shoot this film in Bombay." Because earlier you were shooting in Delhi for this film. This thing happened. Now again, you're unwell. Come back to Bombay and finish this film. Yeah. And now I heard this. This is not happening. Yeah. Our industry ko nazar lagi hai. Here we were 4 days back, 5 days back, recording videos for people to know that you shouldn't get out of the house. Prime Minister, Corona thing, stay in house. And we're doing so well, the country's doing so well. We're following the Prime Minister of this country. But then what has gone wrong with the film industry? Our industry ko kyun nazar lag gayi yaar? One after the other, two best actors, two best human beings. We've lost. Chintu was very close to me, very close to me. We shared moments, dinners, shootings, morning jogging, We've eaten together. We've had tight controls. We used to pack up and travel back in one van. He had one van. I had one van. We used to get into one van. We used to wash ourselves in the studio, sit in the van and start our first thing. I'm going to miss him so much. This is not happening. Yes, madam. Hello?
Sir, we absolutely understand, and it was extremely heartfelt what you shared with us. But also, Shakti Kapoor, you've lost one of your dear friends, and you've worked with him so closely, you know him so closely. Can you share with us some of those special moments you feel while working with him, while having dinners with him, while just going out for a jog, having a casual conversation with him?
There's so many moments, you know, it's going to take me hours. Moments I spend with him are going to be crazy. The food he used to get from home, the best food in the film industry ever, served was from RK Studios, from RK, the brothers. And they used to get such lovely food. The mother used to give them big difference of food in shooting where 10 people could eat. And Rishi Kapoor ke ghar ka khana, shooting mein pura unit, matlab stars sab apna khana chod ke Rishi Kapoor ka khana khane ke liye uske makeup room mein aate the. So this guy was an amazing human being. People thought he's arrogant and he was an emotional guy. He used to be, you know, keeping people away whom he didn't know. But inside, he was a small little child. I know how much we used to laugh together, how much we used to joke together, and how many times you tell me, Shakti, shot ko aise karke dekh, aise karke dekh. We started from Sargam, did Naseeb. What films we done together. And uske alawa, mere ghar mein parties, Rishi Kapoor used to come to my house. I used to go to his house. When he made his new house in Pali, his bar was one of the best bars. And he was such an amazing host, you know. And amazing family. We've been together on holidays. His son and my son and my daughter, we have photographs when they were kids together. And Uti, we've been together. It's crazy to... I still can't digest that he's no more there with us. Sad.
Shaktiji, when was the last time that you had an interaction with him? How many days ago did you speak to Rishi Kapoor? And what was the kind of interaction like?
See, last time when I met him, when we met was very, very recent. It was Mr. Bachchan's party in his house. Amitabh Bachchan threw a party. And me and my daughter and my son had gone. And I met Gentoo. We hugged. We cried. We had tears in his eyes. And he said, Shakti, I'm back. Don't worry. Now we're going to work together. We're going to have same old days time. And he was having a drink, and I was not drinking those days. And he said, cheers, have a sip of my glass. And I had a sip of his glass. And he was looking so handsome. He was looking so healthy. And we were there emotionally. My daughter, he called. He blessed her. My son, they all came and hugged him. And we hugged each other. And then we were every third day on WhatsApp, every third day, for the last 20 days. Can you believe it? I'm just telling it to you. Last evening when I went down in my lobby in my building, I had these kids, you know, all over in the building. And they came to me and they were speaking of Rishi Kapoor. When this thing happened about Irfan, I said, look at him. He recovered. He came back. Even Irfan came back, but something went wrong. Rishi came back. My friend came back. Then I told them, pichle 20 din se mere WhatsApp ka reply nahi de raha ho yaar. And see, through the morning, what happens? This world is strange. Why is it happening to this?
It's absolutely heartbreaking.
Heartbreaking? My wife came and she hugged and we were crying.
Absolutely.
Oh my God. Because Shivangi and Padmani, they've grown up in front of RK Studios and Raj Kapoor family. You know what I mean? And imagine Rishi Kapoor's mother blessed me when I got married. We went to Chambur. My wife took me there. And they blessed me and they gave me a packet of money just keep this little girl happy. And then Rishi Kapoor and Dabbu and Chimpu very close to me. Very close to me, Chimpu also. I'm so sad. Madam, I'm very sad. I'm very sad. I'm talking to you, but I don't know what I'm talking, but I'm genuinely very sad. This is a very bad day. A very bad week, yeah. Terrible, terrible, terrible. This shouldn't have happened. Ah. Yes, madam.
We understand Shakti Kapoor and our condolences there, because you were very, very closely associated with Rishi Kapoor. You've worked with him on multiple occasions. He was like a brother, as you said. And it is understandable what you're going through and what your family has been going through. Shakti Kapoor, please request you to stay with us at this point. And it is extremely heartbreaking because, as Shakti Kapoor said, that he was part of everyone's childhood, and it seems like a part of that childhood is lost today. Sudhir Mishra, if you're still with us at this point. Before I come to Sudhir Mishra, I also have actor Vivek Oberoi, who's also joining us. Vivek, thank you for speaking to us. And it is extremely difficult, needless to say. I mean, I have no words right now to express what the Bollywood fraternity would have been going through right now, having lost two legends in 2 days. It is heartbreaking. It is crushing. Can you share with us your interaction with the Bollywood legend Rishi Kapoor? What was he like? His interaction with you, probably on sets or off screen?
You know, you said it absolutely, bang on. It's a terrible, terrible time for this Bollywood fraternity, this family of ours, to have lost two such pillars in a matter of 2 days. And the saddest part is that, you know, all of us were with them throughout this fight against the disease, against cancer. Hoping, wishing, praying for them to recover and get well soon. And in both cases, one thought that they had made a full recovery and would be ready to join the fold again, to wow us with their incredible performances and their incredible art again. But it's so sad and so shocking that in such a sudden manner, especially with Chintu Uncle, who, when he was back, we were all celebrating that he's fought the cancer so bravely. And he was always such a positive person, with such a positive mindset that, even when you spoke to him when he was ill, it didn't give you the feeling that he was unwell. He was marching on like a soldier and very confident that he's going to win this battle and come back. And for us to hear this news this morning about him first being rushed to hospital and then us losing him as a fraternity, it's truly heartbreaking. I've known him for many, many years. My father's done a lot of films with him, and I've, interacted with him as a school kid, watching his movies and meeting him on the sets of, the films with my father. And I still remember the time when I did my first film and just out of the blue got a call from him of appreciation and encouragement. And that was him. He was a very large-hearted, very secure, very giving kind of actor. Great sense of humor, made you laugh all the time, and then in a split second would be able to transform into making you cry on screen. I think he was truly one of our finest performers, whether you look at his body of work from the lover boy in Bobby all the way to intense performances like Mulk, throughout that journey, the kind of performances, including negative villain roles that he's played almost every shade there is in the spectrum and leaves a phenomenal legacy of work behind. And it's a huge loss to the industry.
Absolutely. And Vivek Oberoi, you've said that you've grown up watching him, you've grown up interacting with him. Can you share with us some of your interactions probably as a child when you had gone perhaps to the sets of the movie of your father while he was working with Rishi Kapoor? What was it like interacting with him from very early on in your life?
I think the fondest memory, he was a really, really fun guy, extremely engaging, extremely fun. That was his nature from the beginning. I remember that from the time that I was a kid. But I think one of my favorite memories of him was when I was studying in Ajmer in boarding school in Mayo. I remember them filming in Ajmer and dropping into our boarding school to see me. And that to me was such a delight, such an incredible experience. The whole school, everybody was working in the school, from the teachers to the faculty to the staff members, all just congregated because Rishi Kapoor suddenly just walked in into our school. And then he just came, spent some time with me, spent an afternoon with me and during lunch break, and then went back to his shoot. That was the kind of, familial bond. That was the kind of love and warmth that he was all about. And it was incredible. He never had any agenda. He was just, a king of his own castle. He was somebody who, was so secure in his own space and as an actor just kept performing. And the things that he's, told me even after I became an actor, the things, when I went through a difficult patch and I was having a string of failures at the box office. I remember him telling me that a film is an attempt. You know, an attempt fails, a film fails, an actor doesn't fail unless you fail yourself in your performances. Keep performing, you know, keep it real, stay true to your art. You know, things like that, they were really, really simple, but I hold so closely to my heart. So he had a huge influence in my life, and I'm truly devastated that he's gone.
Absolutely, and there are several who have said that they've learnt a lot from Rishi Kapoor, his determination, his dedication on the sets, his zeal to excel and also inspire others to do the same. Can you share with us any of your experience in that front? What was Rishi Kapoor like on the sets of a movie when he would rehearse, how he would make his actors, the younger co-stars, they would get inspired from his regiment. He was a stickler to the time, he was very punctual, and that really brought out the real essence of how great an actor he was.
You hit the nail on the head. I mean, it's probably one of my greatest regrets that I've not been able to share screen space with him and, you know, do a film with him. It's something that I've always aspired to and wanted to happen. But what I noticed about him when I was on his sets, watching him, was that, you know, things like you mentioned, the punctuality, the commitment, the dedication, at a time in an era in Bollywood where it was okay, people were lackadaisical, people were okay about being 4 hours late on a set. Chintu Uncle was somebody who was, you know, punctual to the T, you know, and he was always on time, always respected everybody else's time and work. And he didn't make too much of a big deal about it. He was just there. Being a creative part of things. And it was incredible. If you went to him and asked for advice, asked for help, he would offer it. But he would never interfere. He would never step into an actor's space and say, I think you should do it like that, even though he was a legend in his own right, you know, right from the beginning. Such an effortless actor. You know, you give him any kind of piece, any kind of longest monologue, it would be effortless and so real. His performances used to be real at a time where Bollywood was all about style and more about, style and more about playing to the gallery. And at that time, to come up with such real and endearing performances and to connect so deeply, he was incredible.
Absolutely. Vivek Oberoi, thank you for speaking to us and sharing your thoughts. It is extremely difficult, and our condolences for the entire Bollywood fraternity at this point, who have lost an iconic actor like Rishi Kapoor, who has inspired several, who has been an inspiration and admiration for several young budding Bollywood stars as well. Let me quickly go across to Sudhir Mishra, who's still with us. Mr. Mishra, as many of the actors who have just spoken to have said that a part of childhood seems to have gone. Everybody has grown up watching Rishi Kapoor, idealized him, romanticized the way he has played his roles as well. What, according to you, has been the biggest memory of yours, the characters that he has played, and his dedication towards a film, towards a movie, and inspiring the co-stars along?
I know, ever since I've heard the news, I keep thinking of Mera Naam Joker and the first part of it in this young kid called Rishi Kapoor. And I've seen that film over the years. I saw the film as kid, then now I've seen it when I came into the film industry. If you see that performance of that young kid, you know, called Rishi Kapoor, you see a kind of an actor there who's already such a good actor, you know. And then, you know, he went into this whole phase of a romantic, you know, rhythm. Like Vivek was saying, it was an amazingly effortless actor, natural. Not at that moment, that wasn't the style, so maybe underrated as an actor. But, you know, over the years, you know, his performances, great actor. He was just coming into his own. There was this second phase that he was so loving. I didn't do the film with him, but I almost did. So I worked with him in the pre-production and anything that he had an idea, to take a photograph. He was, always working like a young, I have seen, people lose their heads, with two successes. Here was Rishi Kapoor asking me at every step whether I thought what he was doing was right or not. And beautiful people, such passion for the industry, for filmmaking. These are film people. They're intrinsically involved with the film industry. ये जो गाना वैसे ही नहीं है जीना यहाँ मरना यहाँ है वाकई अंदर से उनको यकीन है इस बात ये फिल्म है ये परफॉर्मर्स हैं दीज आर इंडस्ट्री नाउ इट्स देयर आर पीपल हु कैन डू दिस बिजनेस दैट बिजनेस मेक मनी दिस वे दैट वे दीज आर पीपल हु टोटली बिलोंग हियर दिस इज what they do. And look at the, from Siraj Kapoor down to Randhir. It's very difficult to say anything. What a human being. He just sent me a message on the 2nd of March. On the 2nd of April, I lost my father. He sent me a moving message. Now I think I've lost an elder brother.
Absolutely. And Mr. Mishra, we understand it is extremely heartbreaking and crushing for every single individual who has grown up watching his movies, watching him perform all the roles so effortlessly, having had that maturity, having etched a memory of his roles at this point. And Sudhir Mishra, very important because, as you said, he was an effortless actor and it takes a lot of effort, really, to be that effortless actor. But also, if you can share with us, what was your, do you recall any of your last interactions with Rishi Kapoor, perhaps discussing a movie or just off screen discussing about other things? What was your last interaction with him?
No, I remember him, when he was in New York and we were sending messages and then I also met him for the last time at Mr. Bachchan's party. I remember looking for him and then not finding him. And then as I was leaving the party, he was also leaving. And he said, come. This is one of my biggest regrets that I didn't go and see him. I got busy shooting and I thought I'd go and see him.
All right, Mr. Sudhir Mishra, thank you for speaking to us and sharing your thoughts. It is extremely difficult. It is heartbreaking and crushing for not just the Bollywood industry, for every single individual who has grown up watching Rishi Kapoor, feeling loved, a sense of a romance that he did imbibe. And it is extremely crushing at this point for the entire Bollywood fraternity, having lost a veteran actor like Rishi Kapoor.